about ratio. Now today we are going to learn about proportion. So let's learn proportion. Let's look at an example. Do you know what the ratio of the length and breadth our national flag has? Yes, the length and breadth of our national flag are always in the ratio 3:2. Let us check whether the given flags justify this condition. In flag first, length is given 30 cm, breadth is given 20 cm. Therefore, ratio of length is to breadth is equal to 30:20. And when reduce 30/20, so in the table of 10, 3 times come 30, and in the table of 10, 2 times come 20. So the ratio of length is to breadth is equal to 3:2. Now see in flag 2, length is given 120 cm, breadth is given 80 cm. Therefore, ratio of length is to breadth is equal to 120:80. And when reduce 120/80 in simplest form, in the table of 40, 3 times come 120, and in the table of 40, 2 times come 80. So the ratio of flag 2 is also 3:2. Thus, we see that 30:20 and 120:80 are equivalent to 3:2. So 30:20 is equal to 120:80. So children, when two ratios are equal, they are said to be proportion. In other words, two equivalent ratios form a proportion. Proportion is expressed using the symbol proportion, and it is read as is the same as. Thus, the above equivalent ratios are expressed as 30:20 is the same as 120:80. Now, let's learn term of a proportion. In a proportion, A:B is the same as C:D. There are four terms A, B, C and D. And these terms are respectively called first, second, third and fourth terms of the proportion. So here A is called as first term, B is called as second term, C is called as third term and D is called as fourth term. Out of the four, first and fourth terms are called extreme terms or extremes. Means A and D, that is first and fourth terms are called extreme terms or extremes. And second and third terms, that is B and C, are called mean terms or means. Now, let's learn the relationship between means and extreme of a proportion. So, we know that A:B is the same as C:D. So, let's solve one example. Consider 2:5 is the same as 10:25. So, first, in step first, find the product of the extreme, that is A:D means 2:25, which is equal to 50. Now, in step 2, find the product of the mean, that is B:C, that is 5:10, which is equal to 50. So, in this case, we see that product of the extreme is equal to product of means. or we can say that the two ratios are in proportion. Now let's solve one more example. Here the first, second and third terms of a proportion are 9, 15 and 24, and here we find out the fourth term. So let's see the fourth term of the proportion be D. So you know that 9 is to 15 is the same as 24 is to D. We know that the product of mean is equal to product of XT, and here the product of mean means B into C, that is 15 into 24, and product of extreme means A into D, that is 9 into D. So first you multiply 15 into 24 and divide this number by 9. So in the table of 3, 3 times come 9, and in the table of 3, 8 times come 24. Now again cancel. So in the table of 3, 1 times come 3, and in the table of 3, 5 times come 15. Now multiply 5 into 8. So we get the answer 40. So D is 40. Now tell me student, what is unitary method? Let us see it. This is Aman. He went to a stationery shop and bought 5 pens for rupees 75. Now can you tell what was the cost of 3 pens? So let's see. So first find out the price of 1 pen. So the cost of 5 pen is equal to rupees 75. Now what is the cost of 1 pen? So first we divide 75 by 5, and in the table of 5, 15 times come 75. So the cost of 1 pen is rupees 15. Now we can find the cost of 3 pens, but how? So cost of 3 pens is equal to 3 into 15, which is equal to 45. So the cost of 3 pen is equal to 45. So children, to find the value of a number of items from the number of many items, we first divide and then multiply, and this is only called as unitary method. I hope you understood this topic very well. Now I want you to do the rest exercise at home. We will meet in next class. Till then, take care, be positive, and bye bye.